This is Mike Sexton. Want to win at poker, finish in the money, and consistently win at cash games? Join me and other pros at a WPT boot camp. You'll get hands-on training, sharpen all aspects of your game,
I'll let you do it the right way,
and learn to play like a pro. Our 2 and 3 day camps are held at the most famous poker venues. Many students recoup their tuition after just one camp. Our goal is to make you the best poker player you are willing to be. Start winning now. Go to WPTbootcamp.com and put the odds in your favor. WPT Boot Camp, your fast track to the final table.
Welcome back to the Jax50K Cash Game Buy-In. Here are our chip counts, and as you can see, Chris Smith's huge pot win over Tyler Smith is reflected in the totals. By the way, these guys aren't related.
Black red?
Sure.
$1,000 unit, just like before.
Okay. Can't win two in a row.
Want a bet?
I do.
Good to see that the table talk is back on the prop bets, Chris.
All right, Paul's got pocket queens, an unlucky hand at the table so far, and he's going to raise to 1,000. Yet.
I might.
John Racener's going to re-raise to 3,000 with a suited 10-7. You know, sometimes he gets out of line a little, Chris, but we haven't seen him play very much, so this is a raise that's probably deserving of respect.
Absolutely.
Jason, put a free close.
Problem here is Paul's got queens, and he's not going to go anywhere.
I mean, Robl's going to tip you 100 bucks.
Well, a little surprisingly, he just calls. Perhaps
I'm
trapping.
I'm going to tip him with your money. Red. Here we go.
Red.
No. Two black.
Ship it.
Thank you very much. This is an easy game.
All right, all those prop bets have been paid off now. Paul needs to figure out how he wants to play this flop full house. During all the prop bets he had checked, and John bet 4,500, a used Hyundai he'll never see again. Will Paul check raise or just call?
He's thinking, do I want the Hyundai or do I want a Cadillac?
Remember, we still have Winnebagos on the table, too.
That's right. He decides just to call. Nice move here.
The turn is a seven of hearts. That's a great card for Paul as John pairs up.
Wow, two checks. You see the 10 of the hearts on the river. Ricky Ticky Tavi. A horrible card for John. He now has two pair of his own.
Paul will bet 7,500 into the pot of almost 16,000.
This isn't an easy call for John. Three hearts on board, a paired board. An overcard. And John calls and gets the bad news. Paul wins a pot of almost $31,000.
Nice hand.
Thank you.
A little bit good.
It's all right.
Chris Smith enjoying a massage. Yet another great amenity offered by the folks here at the Jax Poker Room. Amenity Pro also provides massages on our Ante-Up Poker Cruises, Chris. I don't know about you, but I always play better when I'm relaxed.
Yeah, nobody touches me at the poker table.
You're so weird. It's the best dollar a minute you can spend. It's so worth it.
I would get 50,000 minutes of massage if we had the money these guys bought in for. All right, Andrew Robles got pocket sixes. Finally a playable hand by our standards. Going to raise to $800.
Paul has queen nine of the big blind defends. We'll see a flop of 8-4 jack, two spades. And Paul's going to check his gut shot straight draw.
All right, Andrew bets 1,200 and gets a quick call from Paul. The turn is the eight of clubs, and Paul again checks.
All The river brings us the six of hearts. Paul's going to make an ill-timed steal attempt, betting 2,600 into Andrew's full house.
Andrew's really hoping that Paul has a naked eight here. Even the jack. And he decides that 16,000 is the right raise amount. But we know it's not.
16,000. It's a cannon shot right there.
That cannon shot was Andrew winning a nice pot.
Come on, straddle, Chris.
Did you really?
I don't think so.
Is that live or did you see?
You goaded him into it.
He figures he's getting like more than that back in equity for now being like a loose, crazy player on television.
I was asking like who was coming to this game and people just kept telling me like, oh, Chris Smith is here. Chris Smith is coming.
Once again, the straddle discussion provides some TV gold for us, Chris.
Thanks, Chris. I wanted you in.
Rick 3 bets Paul to 3,800 with the same hand, ace queen.
You can shove, I'll call you. Let's finally make a TV show.
Seriously.
Yeah. Call. Nice. Nice.
This might be the best pot yet.
Well, Paul doesn't take the bait, he just calls.
I guess I have to continuation bet, right? Isn't that chapter one? Raise the guy who's trying to steal, and then I have to c-bet to make him believe it.
Certainly going to see some action here. As expected, Rick bets, makes it $8,500.
You told me that. Hey, you pay me. I win that bet, right?
She did.
I win that bet. If you shove, I'll call you. You got me, sir.
I'll go home, eat a steak, get up, go back to the airport. Set of sixes is the nuts. Do you think he bought the whole C-bet speech?
Looks like he's contemplating.
Nice. Wow, he really hit a set?
Paul's gonna race to 17,000.
See, this is where Rick's table talk and playing any two cards really pays off for him. Of course, in this hand, he's going to split. But normally, this is the type of hand that he would get paid off on.
Well, he's sick if he's sick if he's got a set of sixes. Well, I didn't bet it to fold and get bluffed. I'm all in. I don't know what I'm thinking. I bet that much. Why the f*** wasting everyone's time? Excuse my
and
language.
We have our first all-in of the broadcast.
I mean, why on earth?
Rick shoves for $36,400.
I guarantee if you fold, I'm going to show the bluff, and I'm going to f*** you off.
It's just begging me to call.
Or the other thing. I read the Book of Tells. I'm looking in the eye and talking a lot. I'm implying that I got it. Of course, it could be reverse psychology. Reverse? I don't know. Mike Caro? What do they call it? The maniac? What's he called?
Mad genius.
Well, I'm far from a genius, but I am that other thing. Thought they could take the heat in Florida, Robl. I thought they were used to the heat down here. Right?
This is Florida. I thought they were used to the heat.
Come on, send me home. Put me out of my misery. Let me call the wife. Tell her I'll be home early. It's okay.
Call.
You deserve it. Okay.
I'll run it twice.
I'll do whatever you want, sir.
I'll run it twice for you.
Twice is nice. I got the best one. I don't
know. Chop it up. Next. Back door, back door. Next. There's no back door here.
And we, of course, are denied our first chance to run it twice since I wouldn't change the outcome. Split pot.
Nice hand, both of you.
Yes.
Well, that would have been sick if you laid it down and he showed you the same hand.
I would have thrown up.
It would have been much better if you had.
I would have thrown up. You talk too much. That's why I called.
I love that Paul says Rick talked him into him calling by, well, talking too much.
Well, at least we're not afraid to get it all in. All these other guys.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back with more high-limit cash game action from Jax Poker Room in Orange Park, Florida.
Take it down and stay protected with world-class custom poker card guards from TakeItDownPoker.com, specializing in custom designs that are handmade in the USA. They make great promotional items for your company events or personal items for yourself, friends, and family. Check them out at TakeItDownPoker.com.